cannot tell who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what is my hope? Truly my hope is in thee. Deliver me from all my offenses, and make me not a rebuke unto the foolish. When thou with rebukes dost chasten man for sin, thou makest his beauty to consume away, like as it were a moth fretting a garden. Every man therefore is but vanity. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and with thine ears consider my calling. Hold not thy peace and my tears, for I am a stranger with thee, and a sojourner as all my fathers were. O spare me religion, that I may recover my strength before I go hence and be no more seen. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever the earth and the world were made, thou art God from everlasting and world without end. Thou turnest man to destruction again. Thou sayest, come again, ye children of men. 4,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday, seeing that it is past and as a watch in the night. And soon as thou scattereth them, they are even asleep and fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and groweth up, but in the evening it is cut down, dried up, and withered. For we consume away in thy displeasure, and are afraid at thy wrathful indignation. Thou hast set our misdeeds before thee, and our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For when thou art angry, all our days are gone. We bring years to an end, as it were a tale that is told. The days of our age are 80 years and 10, and though men be so strong that they come to 80 years, yet is their strength then but labor and sorrow. So soon passeth it away, and we are grown. So teach us to number our days, that we might apply our hearts unto wisdom. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. And my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Because even on a day like today, how many know that the Lord is still good? Do I have a witness in the house that the Lord is still good? His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Amen. And this is not the opening hymn or anything, but we just want to declare that this is a homegoing and not a funeral. And you still, devil, can't make us doubt. Do I have a witness in the house? Why don't you put your hands together and encourage this family? Your trust in him. Amen. We want to thank God for Dr. Williams for allowing us to use the sanctuary today. And so we just ask that you would continue to bless the angel of this house. Amen. And my brothers and my sisters, why don't we just bow in a word of prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you for the life and spirit of our dear sister Jessie. Allow him to know the promise that even when my mother and father forsake me, the Lord will take me up. Lord, we ask that you would take him up in your hands and comfort him in the days to come, God. Lord, you are our strength and our refuge and our bridge over troubled water, God. You make the crooked places straight, God, and you bring the high places down. So even on today, God, rest, rule, and abide with us in this moment. In the mighty, marvelous, and majestic name of Jesus the Christ, and for his sake we pray. Let the church say amen. 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 We're going to join together in the great hymn of the church. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. We ask our dear sister Alicia to lead us into that, in that hymn. Blessed assurance,
blessed assurance, Jesus is mine.
Oh, what a foretaste.
Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine.
Heir of salvation. Saints, this is my story.
Amen. I'm going to be reading the first revision of Psalm, the 23rd Psalm. Psalm written by the shepherd. This is a shepherd's psalm, written by David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters, and he restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thou rod and thy staff comfort me, thou preparest my table in the presence of my enemies, thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over, but surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord, forever and ever. God bless you, in the name of Jesus. Speak to him.
Let not your heart be troubled. We believe in God. Come on, man. Pray.
Father God, we come to God, Lord, knowing that you still feel us wrong. God, we ask you that we can come out of here for a moment. Go heart, mind, God, we ask you to protect this family in a special moment, in a special way, in a special hour, God. Let them know that by and by everything is going to be all right. Oh God, we ask that you just walk with them if they take the next step. We ask, God, that you speak more if they don't have the words. God, we ask that you would let them lift their head up to the hill because they help, because their help comes from the Lord. Oh God, we ask for strength in this hour. God, we ask for peace. God, we ask for comfort for this family. Let them know, God, that they're not only doing right, even though another flower has been picked from the garden, God. This family knows you, God, and you know them, God, and we just ask that y'all clap hands together and pat each other on the shoulder and walk with each other and talk with each other there, Lord. By and by, God, we know that they will look back on this day and say, God is still doing his work. Oh, God, we ask today, Lord, that you would just walk with them, God, as they go through it more than believe. And let them know, dear Lord, that you're sitting on the throne of truth. These are all blessed men. In the mighty power of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Giving honor to God, I say to Lee and the family to know that weeping may endure for now, but joy will come again in the morning. Also know that your Enoch family, beauty choir, and praise team are with you and will continue to keep you in prayer. Why should I feel
We certainly bless and thank God for all that we have seen and heard thus far. And so we're going to ask Deaconess Laura Fisher to come and read all of our cards and resolutions. And I'll be back. Amen. Come on, sister.
Praise and
Thank God for all of the cards and resolutions. And we know that the family will acknowledge them at a later date. This is a time of the service where we ask for remarks, and we're going to keep our remarks to 2 minutes. And what I like to say is save some for the repast, save some for the cookouts. We don't have to tell it all today, but we do want to make sure that we just say or speak well of Sister Stephanie at this time. So if there are anyone in the family has picked to say remarks, you may come at this time. Any friends, relatives would like to give remarks, you may come at this time. So if there are no remarks, we just certainly bless God again for the life and spirit of Sister Stephanie. When we had Bible study, it seems like it was so long ago when we had Bible study in the sanctuary or in our upstairs room. Sister Stephanie would come, and Sister Stephanie would be, Sister Stephanie would sit next to my mother and one of our other saints. And they would just have a good time. I don't even know if they were paying attention. They would be in there laughing and talking. I asked a question and they look up and they all look shocked like they were in grade school. And I had to laugh. It was the funniest thing. But, I just thank God. She always had a pleasant smile and a pleasant spirit. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Yes. Amen. And always encouraging. I would remember I could just be walking past. And I would speak to everybody, and she would make it a point to tap my shoulder and just smile. And I'm like, oh God, you don't know what it means to have that kind of encouragement as a new pastor in the church. And so I praise God for her. Amen. And if she's touched your life and you're in here today, why don't you praise God for the life and the spirit of Sister Stephanie's blessing and blessing. Oh, I believe she deserves a standing ovation. Don't you think so? If she's touched your life, if you tasted her food, if she's smiled on your face, if she's encouraged you, why not? Amen. 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 We are learning to bless the family. Amen. You should be yourself. God bless you. We will have the rich girl, the life story, and then our dear sister, Celeste, will give us a selection, and then we will prepare our hearts to hear the word of the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Tuesday morning, July 4, 2022.
No more pain, no more suffering, no more harm. Chess was the oldest daughter born to the late Don A. Matthews and David Paul, who both preceded her in death. Chess received her education in the public school system in South Carolina. She was a member of the Olive Grove Baptist Church in Florence, South Carolina. Chess was married to Raymond Stephanie, later divorced, then moved to Philadelphia, where she met the love of her life, Henry Smith Sr., and they had one child together. Chess worked at various jobs, including Sears Roebuck, Spiegel Department Store, at the Capone Mill Mall in Virginia, Value Plus Store, and her favorite job, private food nursing. Jessica accepted Christ later on in life as a member of the Enoch Baptist Church under the leadership of the late Reverend W. E. Cook. She served under the number two usher board. Jessica later joined the New Joy Missionary Baptist Church on July 19, 2013. Under the leadership of the late Reverend Joseph Fuller Jr., when she sang on the choir, she continued to sing with the choir under the leadership of new pastor Reverend Edward W. Smith until her health started to fail. Jessie was a beautiful, loving, kind, and compassionate person, always willing to lend her hand. She loved her family and her neighbors, loved to cook. When she did cook, she was cooking up for the whole lot. Oh yes. One of her hobbies were traveling. She loved to stay on the go. Some of the places she started traveling to were Turkey, Greece, Barcelona, Sicily, Italy, France, Vancouver, Canada, Alaska, Hawaii, Bahamas, Belgium, Jamaica, Mexico, and the list goes on. She traveled to these places in cruise line. Her favorite cruise line was Royal Caribbean. She also loved spending time sitting on the porch, talking to her neighbors and listening to music. She needs to cherish her memories. One son, Henry Smith Jr., four brothers, David Hall Jr., Gregory Hall, James Hall, and William Hall, who both preceded her in death. Two sisters, Roberta A. Wilson, Robert Wilson, Joyce R. Pettis, who preceded her in death, her best friend for 29 years, Patricia Butts, and a host of nieces, nephews, and other relatives, church members, and friends. Mama, thank the Lord for my beautiful mother. The Lord she always gave me, the love she always gave me, and her friendship that was never there. For her kind eyes that saw the best in me, and her gentle wisdom that carried me through. For her prayers that lifted me up, and the dreams she held in her heart for me. For the happy memories we made together, and for all the hugs, traveling, teaching, talks on the porch, eating a Sunday dinner, and the memories from. I am so grateful, more than my prayers can express, more than my heart can ever say. I am so thankful to God for entrusting me with the world's most wonderful mother. You take her away.
Dave, Audrey, Kevin, and Ron bought me everything I needed. You even looked for me when I was there, and you didn't have to. You loved me through all of my challenging times, taught me everything I know, and I thank you for that. I am very grateful for you. Your energy, your spirit have changed me and calmed me down. You took me places like Harvard, Atlantic City, and Tony Park. I got to see those things because of you. I appreciate you and I love you. It's been very hard to let you go, but you held my hand before you left and told me I know you can do it. So I know the angels have come down and took you home where you can rest in peace. You'll be dearly missed. I love you always. Your brother, Ray. My sisters, my sister, I didn't know how to say goodbye. So I just didn't say goodbye. I just said I love you. I will miss you and see you in the heaven and on the sky. The place where it is, I'll be happy and never be done. Your brother, son.
Thank you. The Bible declares in the book of Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, verses 1 and 2a, to everything there is a season, and a time for every event, a time and a purpose to every event under the sun, a time to be born, and a time to die. To everything there is a season, and a time for every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die. The word of God for the people of God. Praise be unto God. I called Elder Wilson the other day, and I found out that Sister Jessie had transitioned. As a pastor, I wanted to say something. I wanted to say something deep and profound at the moment. I did my best, but in reality, y'all, I was talking to a sister whose sister had just gone home to be with the Lord. And there are no words that can help that moment, but I did my best. But I started to realize that there were arrangements that had to be made. And the elder is focused right now. She was focused. She had questions for me, and I had to answer the questions. But arrangements had to be made, and plans had to be executed if indeed we could begin to move on from this moment. Making arrangements, y'all, is all about preparation. The sad reality about most of us is that when it comes to this thing called life, we major in that which is minor. How many of us have ever seen people plan for a wedding and not plan for the marriage? Do I have a witness or not? Or how about plan for a trip, y'all, and don't count the cost and find out that they don't have enough to get where they're going? I heard that if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. I understand what it means to make arrangements for funerals. I've had some funerals in my family. I understand what it means to prepare for one's demise, whether it's having a will or securing life insurance. However, the question becomes, now that you have life insurance and you have all of your end-of-life plans together, do you have the assurance that you'll keep on living after you die? Diana Ross asked the question. She said, do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing? Do you know what's going to happen to you when you close your eyes? I mean, if death came knocking at your door today, are you sure? I wonder how many folk can stand flat-footed where you are and declare that if I go right now, I know exactly where I'm going. Do I have a witness in the house? The existential reality for me today, if I'm totally honest, is that sometimes over there is beginning to look better than over here. Do I have a witness? Last week in New York City, 20 people died in an apartment fire in one day. A fire in the Fairmount section of Philadelphia and claimed the lives of 12 people in one family in one day. All I'm trying to say is sometimes over there is beginning to look better than over here. Do I have a witness? In America, over 800,000 COVID deaths ravaged the country all of last year, while only 11% of the African-American community is fully vaccinated. And even right here in the city of brotherly love and sisterly affection, over 500 homicides crimsoned our streets, with many of those being the death of teens and young adults. I don't know about you, but even at my young age, over there is beginning to look a lot better than over here. And so I want to leave you with some thoughts today. today. I want to leave you with some thoughts that I believe Sister Jessie would want us to take with us as we ponder what it means to live here and life after here. Is that all right? The first thing that comes up, Elder, is that she would want us to understand the time value of life. The time value of life. What do you mean, preacher? Well, if you lose money, if you lose your job, if you lose your possessions, you can work and you can pull yourself up by your bootstraps and reclaim all of your losses. Conversely, y'all, what you cannot regain in this life is time. If you really read Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, it talks about there's a time to be born and a time to die, a time to embrace and a time to shun embracing, but it doesn't ever say anything about a time to waste time. Do I have a witness? And so you got to understand that you can get back your money, you can get back your possessions, but you can't regain time. And if you were to look at the front of your program, you would see two dates. And there's a date to be born and a date when Sister Stephanie was born and a date when she passed away. But there was a dash in between the dates. And here it is. The tragedy is not that we will all die. The tragedy is that some of us will die before we ever live. And what are you doing with the dash this morning? Everyone will have a name, will not have their name and lights, but like Sister Jessie, when you had the opportunity, did you take ownership of every moment in your life? Did you take ownership of the opportunity to tether the entire block, the whole block, by cooking meals? Come on now. Did you sit on your own porch and love on your neighbors? Did you know the joys of hanging with your family? And did you make the most of every moment with your friends? Did you lend a hand? Because when you're standing before God, God's not going to ask you what your neighbor did. God's not going to ask you what the government did. He's going to ask you what you did. And Jesus said, I have a reward for how you treated people. Right? When I was hungry, did you feed me? When I was naked, did you clothe me? When I was thirsty, something to drink. Come on now, did you take the time out to lend a hand to someone? Did you pull somebody up while you were climbing up? How about this? Did you travel? Did you see the world? Anybody know what I'm talking about? Do the people in your life know that you love and cherish them? My grandmother would say it like this. She said, we don't miss the water until the well runs dry. She would want us to understand the time value of life, but she would also want us to understand that every day is challenged by a choice. Every day we live is challenged by a choice. And I've preached several funerals, and I've learned that I don't have a heaven or a hell to put anybody in. I tell you, this is a good time to say, like my pastor would say, there's some good in the worst of us. There's some bad in the best of us, but it behooves all of us not to talk about the rest of us. Tell your neighbor, so you live, so you die. Do I have a witness? Moses told the children of Israel, when we talk about being challenged by a choice, Moses told the children of Israel in Deuteronomy, the 30th chapter, the 19th verse, he said, I call heaven and earth to record this day against you that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. Therefore, choose life, that both you and thy seed may live. All I'm trying to say is every day we have to wake up and choose life. Every day we got to wake up and put it on. Do I have a witness? Hear her say, don't you sit down on the steps because you're trying to climb hard. Don't you give up now. Don't you throw in the towel. But every day, son, you got to get up and put on your good suit and comb your hair. The little bit you got left, man, brush your beard off and go to work and get out there in life and live your life. Do I have a witness in the house? Because every now and then, you want to want us to understand that there is a time to die. There is a time to die. A time to let this life go. In order to wholeheartedly embrace the life after this. And what we need to understand that whomever we are when we die is who we want to be when we wake up on the other side. And so listen, if you are dirty rotten scum, when you die, when you lay down, guess what? Then you will be a dirty rotten scoundrel when you wake up in heaven. Conversely, if you believe in the promise of God, I wish I had a witness. If you believe that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, if you believe that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, if you believe that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I believe Sister Jessie chose life on June 19, 2013. She made the ultimate choice and she accepted Jesus Christ as a personal Savior. I want to talk to some people who understand the promise of when you accept Jesus Christ as a personal Savior. The Bible declares that if any man be in Christ, then he's a new creature. All things are passed away and behold, all things have become new. Jesus said, if you believe in the promise of God, watch this, you will have.
service and have a